So hello students and welcome back again to yet another video tutorial. In this video tutorial we would be talking about that how the specification of the terminal segments takes place. What are the terminal segments in the case of Drosophila melanogaster? Terminal segments refers to the terminal anterior and the terminal posterior part of Drosophila melanogaster. Drosophila melanogaster ke andar टर्मिनल सेगमेंट्स का मतलब होता है उसका टर्मिनल एंटीरियर और टर्मिनल पोस्टीरियर पार्ट. अब जो टर्मिनल एंटीरियर और टर्मिनल पोस्टीरियर पार्ट है इट इज़ बीइंग प्रोड्यूस्ड विद द हेल्प ऑफ सर्टेन अदर प्रोटीन्स. फॉर एग्जांपल द एक्रॉन प्रोटीन इज द प्रोटीन दैट इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ द एंटीरियर मोस्ट सेगमेंट. सो द एंटीरियर मोस्ट सेगमेंट इज बीइंग फॉर्म्ड फ्रॉम द एक्रॉन प्रोटीन. Whereas the posterior most fragment is being produced by telson. Telson is going to produce the posterior most segment of this particular Drosophila melanogaster. Both regions are specified with the same signaling pathway. Okay, so whether it is the anterior part formation or whether it is the posterior part formation, both of these are being determined by the same signaling pathway. Okay, so torso expressed ubiquitously in oocyte. Okay, torso protein, as I have already told you, it is being expressed throughout the oocyte. Pure oocyte mein ek protein express hoti hai jiska naam hai torso. Okay, you can look here. There are torso-like proteins, and torso proteins, which is being expressed in the case of oocyte, is actually inducing a MAP kinase cascade pathway. MAP kinase pathway is a type of a receptor tyrosine kinase pathway that will activate the torso signal, and this torso signal is responsible for the expression of the acron in the anterior part and telson in the posterior part. ये जो torso का signal है यही बनाता है acron को anterior part में और telson को posterior part के अंदर. अगर आप यहाँ पर बात करें ध्यान से सुने then you can just look here. See, both torso and torso like protein specify both terminals. It is the torso and the torso like proteins. Okay, torso and torso like proteins are going to specify both the terminals. In the presence of bicoid, that is the anterior pole of the Drosophila melanogaster, is going to be produced. Torso and torso like proteins are going to differentiating into acron, while in the absence of bicoid, torso and torsal like proteins gets differentiated into telson. Now, how does the telson and torso and acron differs from each other? Acron will form the anterior part, whereas telson will form the posterior most segment. ये जो acron होता है ये anterior most segment को बनाता है और telson posterior most segment को बनाता है. Just give me a second. So, just to summarize the chart here. The bicoid protein is responsible for the expression of the acron protein towards the anterior most segment of the Drosophila. The anterior most segment is going to form the antennapedia complex. Okay, so it is the antennapedia complex that would be activated via the expression of the acron protein. Whereas the nanos protein, which is expressed towards the posterior side, towards the posterior side there is another protein which is referred to as telson. Okay, so telson is also going to be expressed towards the posterior side. Telson protein bhi posterior side mein express hoga, aur ye jo protein express ho jayega it is the one which is responsible for the formation of the posterior part of the Drosophila melanogaster. Both regions are specified by the same signaling pathway. They work by the same signaling pathway. So as torso is going to be expressed throughout the egg, पूरे egg के अंदर torso का expression होता है, लेकिन torso के expression को control और regulate कौन करता है? Bicoid regulate करता है. Bicoid होता है, तो torso के साथ में torso-like protein that is acron का expression होता है. कहाँ पर होता है बेटा? Anterior segment में. और अगर bicoid नहीं होता, then towards the posterior segment there is yet another protein which is being expressed, and that protein is referred to as telson. Okay, so this is how both these proteins are going to be expressed. Okay, so you must note these things. Both torso and torso like proteins specifies the terminus. In presence of the bicoid, torso and torso-like protein that is referred to as acron is present, while in the absence of bicoid, torso and torso-like protein that is referred to as telson is present. So acron is present towards the anterior side and telson is present towards the posterior side. This is how the differentiation and the formation of anterior and posterior loci in the case of Drosophila melanogaster occur. Moving to the next slide. Now, here we have to summarize that how the differentiation of the cells takes place. यहाँ पर हम लोग देखेंगे कि differentiation cells का कैसे होता है. You know that during the embryonic development in case of Drosophila melanogaster, you can find there are cells that will be forming the anterior part, cells that will be forming the posterior part, and the terminal groups which are going to be present. You can look here that there are several zygotic genes which are present. These genes involve the gap genes, pair rule genes, segment polarity gene, and lastly the homeotic genes which lead to the formation of a particular part in the developing embryo. Here what you find is that there are certain genes which are going to be expressed much before the formation of zygote. Kuch genes zygote ke banne se pehle hi express ho jate hain. Such type of genes which are being expressed even before zygote formation are referred to as maternal effect genes. And it is these maternal effect genes that will regulate the entire process. Okay, how these maternal effect genes regulate the entire process? They leads to the formation of concentration gradient from the anterior towards the posterior side. ये maternal effect gene concentration gradient को बनाते हैं. बेटा कहाँ से लेके कहाँ तक concentration gradient को बनाते हैं? These will lead to the formation of concentration gradient from anterior towards posterior side. As it leads to the formation of concentration gradient, so it is highly responsible for the formation of a concentration gradient across the embryonic develop across the Drosophila embryo. Then it is these maternal effect genes that will influence the expression of the gap genes. Gap genes will influence the expression of pair rule gene, influencing segment polarity gene and then selector genes. So this is the downstream signaling pathway. एक पूरा signaling cascade है, एक पूरी signaling reactions है, जिसके through Drosophila embryo convert हो जाता है एक adult के अंदर, और उसके अंदर ये सारे genes आपस में मिलके work करते हैं. Now how does these genes work? That we will have to understand and that we will have to look in our forthcoming slide. Okay, so now we will have to look at the segmentation genes. Now, which are the segmentation genes which are present? As you have seen in the previous slide, all the gap genes, the pair rule genes, the segment polarity genes, all these three different types of genes, which are the zygotic genes, are referred to as segmentation genes. All these genes are commonly referred to as segmentation genes. Segmentation genes and are responsible for the segmentation of the developing embryo. Okay, these are the one which are responsible for the segmentation of the embryo, so that different segments in the developing embryo can be produced, so that an effective zygote will get transformed into a complete adult. Zygote se adult banne ke liye segmentation bahut hi important hai, taki effective segmentation ho paye aur segmentation ke baad mein alag alag organism ban sake. Now moving forward and looking at the segmentation genes, okay, the transition from specification to determination is mediated by segmentation genes. Now the transitions or the interconversion of an embryo into an adult is mediated by segmentation genes. Embryo ka adult ke andar parivartit hona, ye transformation kon karata hai? Ye ek specialized category of genes karate hain, and those genes which catalyze these transformation is commonly referred to as the segmentation gene. It is these genes that are responsible for the segmentation to take place, and they are the one for the transition from specification to determination. Okay, it is being mediated by segmentation genes. These genes divide the embryo into a repeating series of segment. It is these genes that will cause the embryo to be segmented. Okay, it is these genes that will divide the embryo into several number of segments. For example, this is the embryo which is present. Okay, this is an embryo which is present. Now this embryo will be divided into several different types of segments on the basis of these segmentation genes. ये जो सेगमेंटेशन जीन्स होते हैं ना, यही एम्ब्रायो को कई सारे सेगमेंट्स के अंदर डिवाइड कर देते हैं. ओके, सो देयर आर सेवरल डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ सेगमेंट. फॉर एग्जांपल, फर्स्ट सेगमेंट, सेकंड सेगमेंट, थर्ड सेगमेंट, फोर्थ सेगमेंट. सो दिस इज हाउ द एम्ब्रायो इज गोइंग टू बी डिफरेंशिएटेड इनटू सेवरल सेगमेंट्स ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ एक्सप्रेशन ऑफ द सेगमेंटेशन जीन्स. दीज जीन्स डिवाइड द एम्ब्रायो इनटू रिपीटिंग सीरीज ऑफ सेगमेंट्स फ्रॉम द एंटीरियर towards the posterior axis. Okay, mutation in these genes leads to lack of certain segments or parts of the segment. Now see, if there is a mutation that takes place in the segmentation gene, agar maan lijiye ek segmentation gene mein koi mutation ho jaye, agar segmentation gene mein koi mutation ho jayega, to embryo ka jo developing koi part hai wo kya ho jayega, wo absent ho jayega. A particular part of the developing embryo will completely become absent. That means a part of the embryo will be completely lost. Embryo ka ek particular part kya ho jayega, it will get lost. Okay, so this type of lost of a particular segment is going to take place. Lack of certain segments, okay, or parts of the embryo is going to take place. Okay, part of a particular segment is going to take place in the case of mutation. Now there are three categories in which the segmentation genes have been categorized. These are gap genes, another one is called as the pair rule genes, and the third one is referred to as segment polarity genes. Dekhiye, teen genes hai जिनमें इन सेगमेंटेशन जीन्स को डिवाइड किया गया है. गैप रूल जीन्स, पेयर रूल जीन्स, दीज आर ऑलवेज वर्किंग इन पेयर, एंड सेगमेंट पोलैरिटी जीन्स दैट विल बी डिटरमाइनिंग द पोलैरिटी ऑफ द ईच सेगमेंट व्हिच इज गोइंग टू फॉर्म द एडल्ट पार्ट ऑफ द ड्रोसोफिला. ओके, एडल्ट ड्रोसोफिला का कोई भी जो सेगमेंट बनने वाला है, उन चीज़ों को डिटरमाइन करने के लिए जो जीन्स होंगे, दोज विल बी रेफर टू एज द सेगमेंट पोलैरिटी जीन्स. नाउ मूविंग फॉरवर्ड, सो as we know that the transition from the specification towards the determination of a particular part of the body is being mediated by a type of genes which are referred to as segmentation genes. Aapki body mein ek particular segment ko banane ke liye ek genes hain. Those genes are called as segmentation genes, and they are the one which are responsible for the determination of a particular body part. These are the genes that are going to divide the embryo into repeating series of segment. Okay, they will be the one that are going to divide the embryo into a repeating series of segments. In the case of insects, you can find that the body of the several different types of insects, as well as the organism belonging to Platyhelminthes, Nematyhelminthes, their body is consist of several number of repeating segments. This is because of the presence of segmentation genes from the anterior towards the posterior side. You might have visualized Ferratema prostoma, that is referred to as earthworm. And in the case of earthworm, you would have also noted that its body is divided into segments. Why these segments are being produced? Because these are the result of segmentation genes. Ultimately, those segments fuse together with each other, and then the higher organisms such as the Homo sapiens, the mammals, the apes, the reptiles, they began to evolve. Okay, so mutations in any of these genes can lead to lack of certain segments. Okay, certain part of the body might be absent because of mutations associated with these genes, or parts of segments might also be absent. So there might be certain part of the segment that might be completely absent. There are three classes of segmentation genes, and these three classes of segmentation genes are gap genes, pair rule genes, and segment polarity genes. Okay, these are gap genes, pair rule genes, and segment polarity genes. These are the genes that are responsible for the segmentation of the Drosophila embryo. Okay, moving forward, that how does these segmentation genes, the gap genes, pair rule genes, and segment polarity genes act? Okay, so let us look at how these genes act. So firstly, gap genes. Gap genes define segment regions in the embryo. गैप जीन सबसे पहले ये रीजन्स को डिफाइन करते हैं कि कौन कौन से सेगमेंटेशन रीजन्स बनेंगे एम्ब्रायो के अंदर, विच आर द डिफरेंट रीजन्स दैट वुड बी प्रोड्यूस्ड इन द एम्ब्रायो. म्यूटेशंस इन एनी ऑफ दीज गैप जीन्स कॉजेज डिलीशन ऑफ एन एंटायर सेट ऑफ बॉडी सेगमेंट. पूरे का पूरा एक बॉडी का सेगमेंट ही डिलीटेड हो जाता है, एंड प्रोवाइड अ गैप अलॉन्ग द एंटीरियर पोस्टीरियर एक्सिस. देयर वुड बी अ कंप्लीट गैप दैट वुड बी प्रोड्यूस्ड अलॉन्ग द एंटीरियर एंड द पोस्टीरियर एक्सिस. एंटीरियर से पोस्टीरियर एक्सिस तक एक सेगमेंट का एब्सेंस होने की वजह से क्या हो जाएगा, एक गैप प्रोड्यूस्ड हो जाएगा. फोर गैप जीन्स हैव बीन वेरी वेल कैरेक्टराइज्ड, एंड दीज जीन्स आर क्रुपिल, giant, hunchback, and knips. Okay, as I was telling you, hunchback has also been included in the maternal effect genes and it has also been included in the gap genes. Hunchback को दोनों में ही include किया गया है. तो यहाँ पर जो genes हैं जो gap genes के अंदर participate करते हैं, those are cripple, giant, hunchback, and then the crips. So these are the genes that are going to take part. Each is expressed in characteristic region under the control of maternal effect genes. ये बहुत important है कि maternal effect genes ही gap genes के expression को control कर रहे हैं, क्योंकि maternal effect genes ही सबसे पहले express हुए थे. Even before the fertilization, they were being expressed. Just after fertilization, when the sperm enters into the egg, okay, then the process of fertilization takes place. After fertilization, there are four types of genes that are going to be activated. One is cripple, another one is giant, third is hunchback, and fourth is knips. Okay, each is expressed in characteristic region under the control of maternal effect genes. ये चारों के चारों characteristic regions में express होते हैं and they are being expressed under the maternal effect genes. So it is the maternal effect genes those which are going to express themselves. Okay, gap genes encodes the transcription factor that can activate or repress the transcription of other genes or pair rule genes. So they will be regulating the transcription factor, they would be activating a particular transcription factor, and they are the one that would be downstreamingly controlling the pair rule genes. Gap genes aise transcription factor ko regulate karenge, aise transcription factors ko banayenge. Ye khud ek transcription factors hain jo pair rule genes ke expression ko regulate karayenge alag alag segments ke andar. Abhi kya aa gaya hai, embryo ke andar gap aa gaye hain. कैसे गैप आए हैं उन्हें देखें. यहाँ पर अगर आप एम्ब्रायो को देख पा रहे हैं अपने सामने, सो हियर यू कैन फाइंड दैट फर्स्टली द हंचबैक इज गोइंग टू प्रोड्यूस अ पर्टिकुलर कंसंट्रेशन ग्रेडियंट फ्रॉम द एंटीरियर टुवर्ड्स द पोस्टीरियर. देन द एक्सप्रेशन ऑफ जायंट इज गोइंग टू टेक प्लेस. आफ्टर द एक्सप्रेशन ऑफ जायंट इट हैज डिवाइडेड द एम्ब्रायो इनटू हेड, थोरैक्स एंड एब्डोमेन. देन टुवर्ड्स द थोरैसिक रीजन द क्रुपल, then crips, and then the tailless is going to be expressed towards the posterior region. So this is how the expression of the different segment is going to take place. Alag alag segment ek dusre se alag alag hote chale jayenge. Okay, you know that why these segments are being going to be produced, so as to cause the differentiation of the cells, taki cells ka differentiation ho sake aur wo ek particular organ ko bana sake. Next, now after the gap genes have produced gap in the Drosophila melanogaster embryo, gap genes jo hain unhone gap produce kar diya tha Drosophila melanogaster ke embryo ke andar. Uske baad mein ek aur gene jo express karte hai, the next series of genes that are going to be expressed are referred to as the pair rule genes. These genes define a pattern of segment within the embryo. These are the one that are going to define a particular pattern of segment formation in the embryo. Okay, a pattern of segment is going to be formed within the embryo. The pair rule genes are regulated by the gap genes. It is these pair rule genes which are being regulated by the gap genes. To pair rule genes ko regulate karne wale jo gene hai unka naam kya hai, gap genes. And maternal effect genes and are expressed in all seven alternating bands along the anterior posterior axis. Anterior se posterior axis pe in all the seven alternate bands. Okay, so they are going to divide the embryo into seven different bands. Okay, and each band will further be divided into two different sub bands. Ye pair rule gene embryo ko saat band mein divide kar dete hain aur har ek band fir se do sub band mein divide ho jata hai, leading to the formation of 14 distinct para segment, because every segment will be divided into two different segments, leading to the formation of 14 different para segments. Okay, mutation of pair rule genes lead to missing several para segments. Okay, so several different types of para segments might be absent if mutation is going to take place in the case of pair rule genes. Pair rule genes mein hone wale mutation kai sare para segments ko delete kar dete hain. Now their pair rule genes have been categorized into two different categories. One is called as the primary pair rule gene, another one is called as the secondary pair rule genes. Now how the primary and the secondary pair rule genes are differentiated from each other, kis tarike se primary aur secondary pair rule genes को हम एक दूसरे से अलग अलग करते हैं. सो प्राइमरी पेयर रूल जीन्स इंक्लूड हेयरी, इवन स्पाइक्ड एंड runt. So hairy, even spiked, and the runt are referred to as primary pair rule genes, whereas secondary pair rule genes which are present are Fuji Terasu, odd paired, odd skipped, paired, and sloppy paired. These are the genes that are responsible for the expression of the secondary pair rule genes. ये secondary pair rule genes के अंदर आते हैं और further embryo को divide कर लेते हैं. Pair rule genes are themselves encode transcription factors which activate segment polarity genes. अच्छा देखिए pair rule genes को activate किसने किया था बेटा, याद करिए, maternal effect genes ने activate किया आगे चल के किसको. Maternal effect genes get activates the gap genes act as transcription factors, activate the pair rule genes. Now pair rule genes will act as transcription factor, will activate the segment polarity genes. यानि कि ये एक पाथवे चल रहा है, ये एक डाउनस्ट्रीम पाथवे है और इसके अंदर आप देख सकते हैं कि एक के बाद में दूसरे जीन्स को एक्टिवेट कराया जा रहा है. यू कैन लुक हेयर दैट हाउ सी the gap genes, the pair rule gene, the segment polarity gene, and then selector genes. So this is a downstream signaling pathway through which different types of genes are going to be expressed. Okay, in even spike mutants, each of the even numbered para segment is missing. Agar even spike mutant banaya gaya hai, for example, even spiked mutant are the one in which even number of segments are absent. Okay, whereas the Fuji Terasu mutants are the one in which odd number of para segments are being expressed. Actually even spiked protein and the Fuji Terasu are being expressed in alternate manner. Even spiked or Fuji Terasu protein alternate manner mein ek dusre ke sath mein express karte hain, ek bar ek express karta hai, ek bar dusra. To agar even spike mein mutation kar doge to even number of para segments gayab ho jayenge. Ye para segments sir kya hote hain and how these para segments are present, for that you have to understand here, you will have to look here. See, in the case of Drosophila melanogaster, there are 14 segments which are present. So the body of the Drosophila melanogaster is divided into 14 different segments, including the maxilla, the mandible, the maxilla, the labyrinth, the thoracic segments 1 to 3, and the abdominal segments from 1 to 8. यहाँ पर मैंडिबल है, मैक्सिला है, लेबियंथ है, थोरैसिक सेगमेंट है, एब्डोमिनल सेगमेंट है, एक से लेके आठ तक. अब हर एक सेगमेंट को फिर से दो पार्ट में डिवाइड किया गया है. वन इज रेफर्ड टू एज द पोस्टीरियर एंड द इंटीरियर सेगमेंट्स. ओके, एंड देन देयर आर स्पेसिफिक पैरा सेगमेंट्स विच आर प्रेजेंट. यहाँ पर केवल सेगमेंट को डिवाइड किया गया कंपार्टमेंट्स के अंदर और इसके बाद में पैरा सेगमेंट्स प्रेजेंट है. एंड दीज पैरा सेगमेंट्स आर द वन विच आर going to be categorized into 14 different types. Now each of these para segments, they are being governed by two different types of proteins. One is even spiked, another one is Fuji Terasu. तो ये Fuji Terasu और even spiked alternate manner में अपने आप को express कराते हैं और फिर वो इन para segments को control कराते हैं. देखिए, in even spiked mutant it is being expressed in each even number para segment. If it is absent, even number of para segment are absent. Fuji Terasu kahan par express hoti hai beta? Fuji Terasu is going to be expressed in odd number of para segment. If Fuji Terasu is absent, odd number of para segments are going to be absent. This is how the differentiation takes place in between them. Okay, in even spike mutant each of the even number para segment is missing. In the case of Fuji Terasu mutant, each of the odd number para segment is missing. This is the division that is going to take place in the developing embryo. Moving to the next slide, so we can now differentiate the gap rule genes into secondary pair rule in the pair rule genes into secondary pair rule genes and the primary pair rule genes. The primary pair rule genes are the even spiked, hairy, and the runt genes which are going to be expressed firstly. Then after their expression on every alternate segment, हर एक अल्टरनेट सेगमेंट पे सेकेंडरी पेयर रूल जीन एक्सप्रेस हो जाएंगे और इसमें आते हैं Fuji Terasu, odd paired, odd skipped, paired and sloppy paired. ये सारे के सारे जीन, सारे जीन कहाँ पर आ जाएंगे? सेकेंडरी पेयर रूल जीन्स के अंदर आ जाएंगे. और बाकी जीन्स कहाँ पर आ जाते हैं? प्राइमरी पेयर रूल जीन्स के अंदर आ जाते हैं. सो दिस इज हाउ द प्राइमरी पेयर रूल जीन्स डिफरेंशिएट फ्रॉम द सेकेंडरी पेयर रूल जीन्स. नाउ हाउ डज द प्राइमरी पेयर रूल जीन्स एंड सेकेंडरी पेयर रूल जीन्स विल एक्ट, दैट वी विल हैव टू लुक फॉरवर्ड. सी एफ टी जेड रेफर्स टू द फुजी तरासू एक्सप्रेशन विच इज गोइंग टू टेक प्लेस. सो फुजी तरासू एंड इवन स्पेक्ट आर गोइंग टू बी एक्सप्रेस्ड ऑन द अल्टरनेट सेगमेंट. ओके, देन देयर कम्स द नेक्स्ट type of or the next category of genes which are also referred to as segment polarity genes. Ek bar gap genes specific gaps ko produce kar dete hain embryo ke andar, to next genes jo aate hain unka naam hai segment polarity genes. These genes define the anterior and posterior compartment of the individual segment. Now the gap has been produced in particular segments. छोटे छोटे टुकड़ों में gaps को produce किया गया है. उन gaps के अंदर भी anterior पे कौन सा organ बनेगा और posterior पे कौन सा organ बनेगा, इस बात को determine करने के लिए हमारे पास में जो genes हैं, those are referred to as the segment polarity genes. So we have certain set of genes called as segment polarity genes. These genes defines the anterior and the posterior compartment of the individual segment along the anterior posterior axis. ये जीन एंटीरियर और पोस्टीरियर कंपार्टमेंट को बताते हैं. दैट हाउ डज द एंटीरियर एंड द पोस्टीरियर कंपार्टमेंट आर गोइंग टू बी प्रोड्यूस्ड अलोंग द एंटीरियर पोस्टीरियर एक्सिस, दैट इज बीइंग डिटरमाइंड बाय द सेगमेंट पोलैरिटी जीन्स. सेगमेंट पोलैरिटी जीन्स इस बात को इंश्योर करते हैं कि हर एक सेगमेंट के एंटीरियर में क्या बन रहा है और पोस्टीरियर में क्या बन रहा है, इसको डिफाइन किया जाए. ओके, म्यूटेशन इन द सेगमेंट पोलैरिटी जीन कॉजेज अ पार्ट ऑफ ईच सेगमेंट टू बी रिप्लेस्ड बाय मिरर इमेज कॉपी ऑफ एन एडजस्टिंग हाफ सेगमेंट. अगर एक पार्ट को आपने रिप्लेस कर दिया दूसरे से, तो एक पार्ट को आपने एब्सेंट करा दिया, तो दूसरा पार्ट उसकी जगह पे आ जाएगा. ओके, अलोंग द सेगमेंट पोलैरिटी जीन्स टू आर वेरी वेल स्टडीड. वन इज रेफर टू एज इंग्रिल्ड एंड अनदर वन इज रेफर टू एज विंगलेस. सो इंग्रिल्ड एंड विंगलेस आर वेरी वेल स्टडीड. ओके, सो हाउ डज द इंग्रिल्ड एंड विंगलेस आर गोइंग टू फंक्शन, दैट वी हैव टू सी. Ingrid encloses a transcription factor, Ingrid itself is a transcription factor, and wingless encodes a signaling molecule. Now, the expression of both these proteins are dependent upon one another, and it these takes place with the help of another protein called as armadillo. Now see, supposingly this is a hedgehog protein, okay? Now see, there is a gradient of a protein that is wingless. यहाँ से एक cell wingless protein को बना रहा है. एक बार विंगलेस प्रोटीन बनी, विंगलेस प्रोटीन जिस रिसेप्टर के ऊपर जाके बाइंड कर जाती है वो रिसेप्टर होता है फ्रिजिल्ड का रिसेप्टर, फ्रिजिल्ड प्रोटीन रिसेप्टर. फ्रिजिल्ड प्रोटीन दैट देन इट इज गोइंग टू डीएक्टिवेट द एफ द जेड डब्ल्यू थ्री प्रोटीन, एंड जेड डब्ल्यू थ्री प्रोटीन इज गोइंग टू एक्टिवेट द आर्मेडिलो. आर्मेडिलो प्रोटीन एंटर्स इन टू द न्यूक्लियस. Once this enters into the nucleus, it acts as a transcription factor. Armadillo खुद एक transcription factor की तरह work करता है. वो activate करा देता है दो और genes को. One is referred to as Ingrid, another one is referred to as Hedgehog. So there are two proteins which are going to be activated. One is commonly referred to as Ingrid, another one is commonly referred to as the Hedgehog. So these are the two proteins that are going to be activated, Ingrid and Hedgehog. Once the activation of Ingrid and Hedgehog is going to take place, then the Hedgehog is going to be secreted. As Hedgehog is going to be secreted, the Hedgehog is going to bind to a patched receptor. Hedgehog ek receptor pe jaake bind karega, aur us receptor ka naam kya hai? That receptor is commonly referred to as the patched receptor. You must know this particular name, patched receptor. Patched receptor, once it binds to the patched receptor, it is going to activate a protein referred to as cubitus interruptus. Cubitus interruptus will lead to transcription of wingless and wingless protein will be produced. ये एक cyclic process है जिसके through Ingrid wingless को और wingless Ingrid को बनाता है. देखो wingless protein ने किसे बनाया? Wingless protein is the one that will lead to the expression of the Ingrid protein. And once the Ingrid protein is going to be produced, then it will cause the expression of wingless. तो यहाँ पर क्या हो जाएगा? यहाँ पर जो segment बन रहा था, जहाँ पर gap genes ने gap produce किया है, वहाँ पर pair rule genes ने pair में segment बना दिए. अब हर एक segment में एक साइड में तो ये एक्सप्रेस हो जाएगा कौन सा प्रोटीन? विंगलेस. दूसरे साइड में कौन सा हो जाएगा? इनग्रिल्ड. तो विंगलेस और इनग्रिल्ड अल्टरनेट मैनर में प्रेजेंट होंगे ना. वंस दिस विंगलेस एंड इनग्रिल्ड आर प्रेजेंट इन अल्टरनेट मैनर, देन दे विल फॉर्म द एंटायर सीक्वेंस ऑफ cells in the case of Drosophila melanogaster. ये Drosophila melanogaster में sequence of cells को बना देंगे. They will form the different sequence of cells in the case of Drosophila melanogaster by their own over expression. अपने ही over expression से ये अलग अलग segments of cells को बनाते चले जाएंगे. This is how segments of cells will be produced in the case of Drosophila melanogaster. Now after the expression of the segment polarity genes, now we would be looking at the homeotic selector genes. And the homeotic selector genes, we are going to look forward that how the different organs are going to be produced in Drosophila melanogaster. Kaise har ek segment mein organs ka formation hoga, wo hum homeotic selector genes ke andar dekhenge. We would be looking at the antennapedia complex, the bithorax complex, and the antennapedia complex including enzymes, the labium, the pseudopodia, the DFD genes, SCR genes, the antennapedia complex, the bithorax complex, the ultrabithorax, the abdominal A and abdominal B in our next forthcoming lecture. So up till now we have finished the maternal effect genes, the gap genes, the segment polarity genes and the segmentation genes. Okay, segment polarity genes, all of these were referred to as the segmentation genes. So this is what we have finished gap rule genes, pair rule genes and the segment polarity genes. In our next lecture we would be looking at the homeotic genes and how the particular organs are being produced in the case of Drosophila melanogaster. Okay, so stay tuned. I will meet you tomorrow at 8 p.m. That's all for today. Thank you. Thanks a lot.